Hi, this is Jaya. In this video, we shall see the summary of Fortunately, the Milk by Neil Gaiman. Neil Gaiman was born in Hampshire, UK, and he has written books for both the adults and the children. And his important works include Carolyn and Stardust, the Doctor's Wife episode of Doctor Who, and in that he himself has appeared as himself in The Simmons. And Neil is also the first author to have won both the Carnick and the Newbery Medal for the same work, that is the Graveyard Books. And his novel was also the recipient of the UK's Book Trust Prize for Teenage Fiction. And he has also received the Locus Young Adult Award and the Hugo Best Novel Prize. And this novel was also shortlisted for the Killip Kate Greenaway Medal for its illustration. And he has also written picture books which include The Wolves in the Walls and The Day I Swapped My Day for Two Goldfish. In this novel, that is the Fortunately the Milk, we find a boy narrator who goes and opens a fridge and he checks for milk to have his breakfast for his tortoise. And there is no milk in the fridge and his mother has also gone for a conference to present a paper. So he goes and informs his father that there is no milk in the fridge and his father goes out to buy the milk. And meanwhile, we find that the boy and his younger sister, they wait for their father to come back with the milk. They wait and they wait. And how long they waited is beautifully described by a picture which shows a clean, pristine, clean house which his mother had left. And now, after the waiting, the floor is strewn with books and papers and all that shows that they have waited endlessly for hours and hours. The boy plays on his electronic device and his sister practices violin. Then the father returns and he returns with the milk and also with the story to tell them. He tells them that he went to the shop and he bought the milk. And when he came out of the shop, he heard a noise coming from a silver disc which was just hovering above Marshall's Road. Suddenly he was sucked into that mission. And fortunately, said the father, since I had the milk in my coat pocket, the milk was safe. And inside on the boat, he saw green globby beings and those beings demanded the father to hand over the ownership of the whole planet. And why they wanted the planet is they wanted to remodel it. Instead of that, the father leaped out through a door marked emergency exit. Actually, the other captors warned him not to jump to it because that will let him into the space-time continuum. But he wanted to exit from there, so he did it. And when he jumped, he kept hold of the milk tight because he had to bring it back home to give his children their breakfast. In fact, throughout the novel, we find that the father is very particular about keeping the milk safe. And here, next we find him hauled up onto a little ship. And this ship is owned by the queen of the pirates and she accuses him of spying. But the dad shows the milk and says that he came to buy milk for his children for their breakfast. And a mission had absorbed him in. And when he tried to escape from there, he fell into her ship. And seeing the milk, the pirate queen understood his situation. And she also tells him that the father had fallen into the 18th century. And understanding his quality, his nature and character, she offers him a Spanish Dublin and also a chance to join her crew. But he refuses, saying that he has to go home because his children will be waiting for him. And his refusal makes the pirates to walk him on the plank. And when he's walking on the plank, he finds that piranhas are circling below. And he knew that he had to be very careful, otherwise he'll fall down and they will really kill him and eat him up. At this time, his son breaks into the story and asks the father, "Piranhas are a freshwater fish. What were they doing in the sea?" And the dad says, "You are right, the piranhas were later." And he continues and he says, as he was walking on the plank, he saw a rope ladder extended from a hot air balloon. And that was a good chance for him to escape. And actually, that balloon was put by the pilot, Astigarasus, called Professor Stig's floaty ball person carrier. And then he gets into the hot balloon. And Professor Stig believes that they are 150 million years in the future. And the father remembers that the pirate queen had told that they are in the 18th century. And so he says that they are roughly 300 years in the past. Then he presses a big red button in the balloon. And dad and Professor Stig find themselves 1,000 years back in the time where they are put in a jungle which is inhabited by volcano god worshippers. They get into the wrath of Splod, that is the volcano god, and the father loses the milk, and then he searches for it and somehow he finds it, because the most important thing for him is the milk and getting it back to his house. Then dad and Professor Steak, they encounter some scary vampires, and in order to escape them, the dad presses the big red button which takes them back to the aliens. And in order to scare the aliens, the dad pulls out 2 cartons of milk from Professor Steak's tiny space-time portal and threatens to touch them together. Because if 2 things which are the same but from different time period, if they touch, the whole universe will end. Or 3 remarkable dwarves will dance through the streets with flower pots on their head. And at this point, the galactic police, they come and they charge the aliens with the crime of breaking into people's planet and redecorating them. And as they keep traveling, they twice get hold of the green stone coming at it from different time trips. Fortunately, they somehow solve the problem without touching the 2 green stones together. Then dad shakes the hand of one of the police officers. At that time, 2 milk cartons touch. But fortunately, the dwarfs appear and the universe is safe and does not come to an end. And Professor Steak has also invented a time machine that requires a special shiny green stone. So they start searching for the stone, and there are a series of adventures which happens at that time. And finally, the father returns to his present with milk in his hand and an extraordinary story to tell to his children. And in the story, we find that the father is a resourceful person, ever protective of the milk. And throughout the story, only one goal is in his mind. That is, he wants to return to his children and give them a good breakfast. So this is the end of the story. And the father has the milk to prove that the story is true. So this is a beautiful story written by Neil. If you have anything more to add on to what I've said, please write it in the comment box. Like the video, share it with your friends. And if you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe. Thank you.